Starting with a three-quarter view, that's a view like this one here. You see parts of the front and parts of the sides, and so you can define already the sculpture of the car and also the character, the face of the car.
And I guess if there's a front three-quarter view, there's also a back three-quarter view, right?
Yeah, exactly.
There's and then you have the whole car.
Then you have the whole car, and then designers are designing the car from other angles so that you see everything. And then you can go with these sketches to the modelers and they start putting it into 3D in the computer.
Okay.
That you can really turn it.
Very interesting. Guys, do you have any more questions? Number plate is clear. Kidney is clear. How fast? We will solve that question later on. When will the car will arrive on the market?
Yeah, it will be in the market later this year.
Okay.
So pretty soon. And yeah, then you will see later the other derivatives of this car.
Did we talk about the kidney and the different styles? We already did
that? I don't know if you talked about it, but I can mention this. This is the Cerium Gray trim. This is coming with the Yam Performance car.
Cerium Gray here and on the mirror caps.
On the mirror caps.
And in the back, the badge.
And in the back, exactly.
Yeah.
But then you can have this kidney in high gloss black, of course. A lot of customers want the black car. They don't like the accent color. And of course, you can have this in alloy matte.
Okay. And over there we have parts made of carbon, right?
Exactly, yeah.
And also the mirror caps are made out of carbon. I have a question from the community. You guys are asking, who is the car made for? Like, who is the customer for this car?
And the customer for this car is kind of a very expressive person, of course.
Okay.
A person who wants to show what it has, wants to express personality, of course. Maybe.
Maybe me.
It's probably you. And
okay.
Of course, it's a person who doesn't hide itself. It's exaggerating their own personality. It's expressive, exactly. If the car is driving by, as I said before, it's a head turner.
It's a
It's a hair turner.
Okay.
And of course, you will kind of be seen in this car.
Okay, very cool. So, if you have to sum up, just tell me four design highlights, because we are with the 4 series, so therefore, four design highlights of this car. What would you mention?
I would say, of course, for us designers, it's always important to make great proportions. So, this car has BMW proportions at its best, I would say. If you compare the 3.0 CS in this car, it's kind of the same character. It has the same kind of clues, design clues.
I have a question in between. What is this color and that one? Ah. You didn't mention them.
Yeah, that's true. So this is a new color, exactly just developed for this car. It's called Arctic Race Blue. Arctic Race Blue.
Race Blue, okay.
And it shows a lot of depth and shadow, so you see the sculpture very good. You see it here. There's a lot of contrast created by this color. This one is the Fjord Blue. It's also very nice.
Shows it was structure as well very good.
Yeah, colors are always reflecting the times, so this is standing then for 70s, for different times.
Okay.
And this is a very modern color here, but both nice, of course. Both are fitting. And
we were talking about highlights.
Highlights?
Yeah.
Exactly, of course.
Yeah.
So I would say the kidney. Everybody should wait to see this one on the road. You will like it. You will
I have
like
to admit
it.
That the first time I saw the car on the picture, I was like, I don't know, I'm not sure about it. But the first time I saw it today live here, I was like, okay, it's cool.
Yeah, that's cool.
It's really cool.
And you have to see it live. So pictures are always are not reflecting what a car looks like. And of course, how the kidney is integrated in this car. For example, here, the BMW logo is slightly tilted forward. You have a lot of sculpture here that's also, for me, a certain highlight.
I really love that because it shows that there's love in details.
There's a lot of love in detail, exactly. Then, what I mentioned before, it's the muscles of the car, like the fenders in front and rear. That's very nice. I think the whole sculpture here is just beautiful. And besides that, of course, here the rims, the wheels, if you look at them, they are also very three-dimensional. They are very technical looking. There's a lot of, let's say, impression here. And
and also they're frozen, right?
Yeah, that's a frozen paint.
Yeah,
and
it's gorgeous.
This is, makes the wheel just stunning. Yeah, that's a highlight for me. And then, of course, let's say the overall proportion of this car, because
this is altogether.
Altogether, the whole car, the whole impression of the car, the stance it has, that's very nice.
Somebody's asking if the aerodynamic is better than the previous one.
Yeah, it's better.
Yeah, it's better.
So we're always looking. No, we are always looking. No, it's way better. Of course, we are always looking for a better aerodynamics. That's always important for us. That's very important for the performance of the car, for the fuel consumption, and so a lot of details here. For example, are meeting the aerodynamics. So you need some space here for good aerodynamics, so that the air can flow around the wheels. In the front, we have the air curtain here, of course. Then in the rear, also defined edges where the airflow can be cut away here and here, for example. So there's a lot of features which are kind of making the aerodynamic better.
Somebody is talking about the electric or hybrid version of the car. So the 4 Series brings in the new topic of power of choice.
Exactly, yeah.
Can you explain that a little bit? Power of choice sounds like nothing to get. So
the power of choice, so of course, as everybody knows, this car will be, not this car, but a car will come, which is the i4. And the customer can choose between the 4 Series, which is combustion engine, or a PHEV, or a fully electric car. And that's the power of choice.
Okay, so that means I'm, as you said, the typical 4 Series driver.
Yeah.
A little bit expressive.
Yeah, exactly.
And I'm living in the city, so I can say I want to have an electric vehicle. Yeah. I get the 4 Series with a pure electric car, as a pure electric car.
Yeah, it will be slightly different, of course. But you have the choice to drive the car which is fitting to your needs and which will look beautifully, which will be a true BMW.
And is that only possible for the 4 Series, or the X3 is offering that as well? And more cars?
Exactly. Yeah. So the power of choice is kind of something special which you get at BMW.
Okay, very cool. And somebody's asking again about the market launch. You said later this year, in autumn and fall.
Yeah, in autumn this car will be launched. I think it's September.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, very cool. Guys, you have more questions? Seems like Christopher answered all your questions you wanted to have and be answered. So thank you very much for your time, Christopher.
Anytime.
And hope to see you soon again. And guys
Thanks
out there, keep online, leave comments, and see you on the next episode of BMW Today or here on IGTV Live. Thanks.
Okay.